बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ महमूद हुसैन। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट Neo4j, अ ग्राफ डेटाबेस टूल दैट कैन बी यूज फॉर नॉलेज रिप्रेजेंटेशन फॉर AI एजेंट्स। इन दिस वीडियो will move further. As we have seen in the last lecture that how to, what is Neo4j, what is a graph database, and what is Neo4j, and then what is Cypher, and then how to download Neo4j, how to install Neo4j, and how to make a simple sample graph database. We made a social network last time with three nodes, and then we have seen the very basics of Cypher query language to make graph database. So in this lecture we will see how to explore already given graph base or knowledge base and how to extract some facts out of the knowledge graph. We will learn how we can write step by step cipher to extract those facts, and then step by step gradually we will make some complex ciphers. We will increase complexity step by step, and we will also see along with constructing cipher that how to write efficient queries and optimized queries in cipher. First of all, I will show you that how we can randomly extract some facts, and then I have already written some cipher queries for to extract some facts. I will show them to you, and in the end we will see the further learning resources. So let's start. First of all, you need to run Neo4j, and you need to make a new project. Let's rename it like name it with the lecture name, and then we make graph. Okay, for this purpose we are going to see a movies graph database that is already provided by the Neo4j. So let's say we make like movies graph, and this is very important part, keyword password. You should be very careful in making this password, and you need to remember it, otherwise this graph won't work and it's a little bit difficult to recover that password. So first of all we will start this graph, and when it will be green in status and it will be running in status, then we will move further. So this graph database we are going to use is made using IMDb data that is currently available on IMDb website. So this is not a complete IMDb graph database, it's just a part of that data. Okay. So let's open browser to make this database. So when you will come on this site, the first section shows you the information about database. We will see this later, and when you will click on favorites, you see that here we have example graphs. So when you will click on it, you see that we Neo4j provide us two built in graph databases. One is movies graph, another is Northwind graph. So we'll click on this movies graph. This is a play command that actually used to run tutorials. So we will just click on this play button. Okay, so first of all, it will show you a basic tutorial about this database. It will show you that what this database consists of, and what is and what this guide will show you further. So I will recommend you to follow this guide thoroughly. So when you will move next, you will see here we have a complete cipher, and that have ability to create all of the database instantly. So when you will just click on it, you will see all the cipher will be loaded in this query bar. And if you see that last line number is 509, so what does that mean? That whole of the database, complete database, is represented in this cipher. So whenever the cipher will run, the complete database will be created in the memory instantly. So you can see this is a power of cipher, just a text, and it would be stored in few KBs, but it has ability to represent all of the database. So cipher can create huge database instantly in memory, and this cipher is stored in very little space, because all of this cipher is just text. So when we will click on this play button again, this whole database will be created instantly. But before creating, let's see this tutorial a little bit more. So also, you can also click this button, cipher and create, to get more understanding about cipher and create commands if you have not practiced them earlier. So if you will move on, yes, this is a very important part. They have already shown you that how you can find out some basic information out of the graph, and they are giving you the queries against each of these information. So you need to explore them one by one, and if you will move on, they will show you. You can also see that they have shown this shortest path query as well here. So I would recommend you to utilize all of them and try to understand all of these queries, and based on the facts they are extracting from the graph base. So this is very important query in the end, that match detached lead end. So it's used to completely destroy your database, completely delete all of the database. So must remember this as well. Okay, now let's click on this play button to create database. So all of the database is instantly created, and this is not a complete database, this is just a chunk of the graph that is displayed here. So you can also see the information of database here, that this graph have 171 labels and 253 relationships, and these are the types of relationships within the graph base, and these are the labels, types of nodes, and these are the properties occupied by nodes and relationships. So if we want to see, first of all, if we want to see that how many nodes are there in the database, so you can just use this match query, match n, and then return. If we will do this return n, then all of the nodes will be appear there. So if we use count keyword, I would recommend to always use the keywords in fully capitalized manner. So you can see we have 171 nodes here in database. So this is not complete IMDb data, it's just a part of the data. Okay, let's move on further. Let's examine this database, this graph a little. So here we have two types of nodes, person node and movie node. person nodes are represented in orange color, and movies nodes are represented in yellow color. So if you click on any person node, you can see that only this information is provided to us, like born and name, and this ID is by default given by new project. So only these two attributes, born and names, are given to us. And if you click on this movie node, so you can see only three attributes are given: released, tagline, and the title of movie. Okay, the interesting thing is, okay, first of all, let's see that there are what kind of information is available on the edges. So you can see we have directed and acted in as a label of relationships. As a label of relationships, so if you click on directed, so we have no attribute in this relationship, but if we click on acted, we have role as an attribute. But clearly all of the person node, if you see all of the person node, none of them have information like which person is an actor or which person is a director. Okay, so there are all the available edges that are showing us that this person directed this movie and this person acted in this movie. So there is no given in the person node, there is no given information in the person node that could distinguish the person that who is actor and who is director. But we can extract, we can get this information out of the graphs by analyzing these edges.